It's time for the RMAC Radio Show, featuring all the latest information from around the Rocky Mountain Athletic Conference. The RMAC is a proud member of NCAA Division II. Now, here's your host, Eric Danner.
Welcome to the RMAC Radio Show, week number 8. My name is Eric Danner. We had the game that a lot of people have been talking about in RMAC football this past weekend, CSU Pueblo and Nebraska Kearney. We're going to talk a lot about that on this episode of the RMAC Radio Show. We're going to also preview the RMAC Cross Country Championships, which will be coming up this Saturday. John Escobel from Regis University going to join us on that. And then we'll wrap things up in the final segment. We're going to start with that big game, CSU Pueblo defeating Nebraska Kearney by a final of 27-14. Stephen Dickens, 7 tackles and 2 key interceptions. He is our RMAC Rawlings Defensive Player of the Week and the Special Teams Player of the Week. It seems like we should probably just name this the Kyle Major Award. This guy's won it so many times. He is our Special Teams Player of the Week, 2 for 2 in field goals, had 9 points in that big victory over the University of Nebraska Kearney. And we're now joined on the RMAC Hotline by the head coach of the Thunderwolves. His name is John Riston. Coach Riston, how's it going today?
Going great, Eric. How are you guys doing?
We're doing pretty good. I got to imagine, Coach, you're feeling pretty good now. This game, they all seem to be getting bigger and bigger. I mean, you start off the season with West Texas. You had kind of that gauntlet here, ending with Nebraska Kearney, where you had to play Shadron, Mines, Kearney, 3 really tough opponents, and you got to be feeling pretty well about how your team's playing right now.
Well, I'm really proud of our team and the way they've responded through this. Eric, we still got a lot of football to be played, and so, you know, what we did Saturday just leads us to the opportunity to go win another game on the next Saturday and then the next step. But the reality of this thing is that we have never beaten Kearney in our 3-year history kind of starting. And so our guys are really excited about the challenge of going and playing Kearney, and we're able to pull it off. And I know that it was a tough day for both teams because of the wind blowing, but I was really proud of our guys, the way they responded and fought through some adversity.
Talking with John Riston, the head football coach at CSU Pueblo, the Thunderwolves now 5-0 in the RMAC. They're 7-0 overall. And, Coach, every week, I mean, these games, it seems like you're not blowing the doors off of people. We've had a chance to see a few times now. I guess the Mines game, maybe about as big a margin of victory as I've seen in person, went down and saw you guys play at Adams. That was a tough game. This game against Kearney, West Texas, you know, that game went down to the wire. But you're winning tough games on the road, and I suppose that's a true mark of a champion.
Well, the obvious is you got to win them. You got to beat everybody, and you got to have a chance to do that, whether it's on the road or here at home. And so, you know, we try to pride ourselves on being a great road team and a team that plays well here at home. And sometimes you're able to have that formula, and right now our formula is good. We got a lot of guys playing really hard, and I think we got a great team attitude. I think our attitude and chemistry is really outstanding, and sometimes as a coach you got to learn how to just get out of the way, and I think I'm at one of those points with the guys that we got. So I feel very lucky, and you mentioned earlier about the margin of victory or doing all those things. Hey, it really doesn't matter as long as you win by 1 point.
Talking with John Riston, head football coach at CSU Pueblo, the Thunderwolves are going to be ranked in the top 10 this week. And, Coach, this is your 4th year, and a lot of these guys have been with you from the start, most notably Lee Meisner, who's going to be our Academic Player of the Year. We're going to release that on Tuesday, so people, when they hear this on the radio, that will already be known information there. You see guys like Jesse Lewis have been with you from the start, and you really built this kind of from the bottom up. I mean, we've seen different ways people build programs, and they go the junior college route or get a lot of transfers in. You've really done this with a lot of kids from their freshman year of high school, and really a lot of Colorado kids too.
Yeah, we wanted to, you know, not have a quick fix and try to get a lot of JC transfers, or we wanted to build it from a ground roots from the state of Colorado as our home, and try try to do a great job of recruiting the best athletes that we can get. And obviously, we got some kids from Texas and California and Arizona and sprinkle them in there. But we got to make sure that we are able to recruit the best kids in Colorado, and that's kind of what's happened. And we have 26 guys that started the first day 3.5 years ago. And so they're still with us. Some of them are seniors in the last year of their eligibility, but some are redshirts. So we got a nice little combination of older players that have kind of been through the experience factor. And when you have that, you got a chance, because it's so hard to coach experience. You can practice it. You can do those things. But in a game-time situation, a lot of these guys have been through it since their freshman year, and now they're reaping the rewards of doing that.
CSU Pueblo, they're going to be hosting Colorado Mesa University. That's a 6 p.m. kickoff at the DeRose Thunder Bowl. Coach, now you're getting all this national notoriety. We saw you on national TV a few weeks ago. USA Today's writing a story on you. Saw NCAA.com doing a piece. I guess part of your mission now, Coach, is yeah, your team's doing really well, but you don't want them to maybe get overconfident. Is that something you're kind of watching for now that the shift has happened, where you've beaten Kearney and now everybody's going to be slapping all the kids on the back and telling them how great they are?
Well, I think it's very important as a coach is now this is your most important role. You got to really step up and lead these guys. And you know, my point is, who are they going to listen to? And they can listen to everybody that, you know, slapping on the back and make them feel good. But the reality of it, those guys are the same people. If we lose or stump our toe the next couple of weeks, they're the one to say, "I told you so," type of mentality. So, you know, we got to lock arms. We got to finish this thing. And when it starts this week versus Mesa, and we're looking forward to that rivalry that we've kind of developed with them. Coach Romano has done a great job over there. You know, those guys have been in the playoffs. They've been where we want to go. And so we're looking forward to that opportunity. And we got to guard against that, but I think we got a mature group. We got a veteran group. And they know what's at stake. But I got to be my best here as a coach is to make sure we stay focused the next 4 weeks.
Well, Coach, we want to thank you for taking some time out, and good luck the rest of the way.
Eric, I appreciate it, and thanks for all the things you do.
All right, that is John Wriston, head football coach at CSU Pueblo. The Thunderwolves now 7-0, and as we tape this, haven't seen the national rankings come out just yet, but you got to imagine Thunderwolves will get into that top 10, knocking off number 4 Nebraska Kearney 27-14. And even bigger picture, we're hoping to get 2 teams in the NCAA playoffs. Only 6 teams in our region get to go. It's kind of a rarity to see 2 teams get in, but you never know what can happen the rest of the season. But CSU Pueblo definitely at 7-0, 5-0 in the RMAC, in good shape for that. Elsewhere around the RMAC this past week, Chadron State defeats New Mexico Islands 42-14, the Eagles forcing 8 turnovers, and Phil Rivera ran back an interception for a touchdown in that one. He, of course, was one of our great sprinters in the last RMAC Outdoor Track and Field Championships. Chadron now 3-2 in the RMAC. Highlands has now lost 3 in a row. They dropped to 2-3 in the Rocky Mountain Athletic Conference. Colorado Mines goes to Mesa. They win 28-20. Diamond Gillis, one of the top names in the RMAC, 189 yards receiving and a touchdown. Alex Vigil with 12 tackles. Connor Wright, 10 tackles for Mesa State. He's having a fantastic season for Joe Romano. Fort Lewis gets their first win of the season in the RMAC. They go, they win at home against Western State 27-10. Tim Jenkins, 18 of 30, 245 yards passing and 3 touchdowns, is our RMAC Rawlings Offensive Player of the Week. So the Skyhawks now 2-5 overall. And Adams State, they win a barn burner against Western New Mexico 44-40. Turjan Saffold, 147 yards, 2 touchdowns. Adams now 2-3 in the RMAC. Western New Mexico drops to 3-2. David Ingram, huge day, 487 yards passing, 5 touchdowns. Also rushed for 85 yards and a score in the loss for the Mustangs. And for more on what's happening in RMAC football this week, let's head over to Chris Poulton at the RMAC Sports Desk.
Thanks, Eric. Only 4 more weeks of conference play, and for CSU Pueblo, destiny is in their hands. The Thunderwolves coming off a decisive win over the Lopers in Kearney and are now ranked 8th in the nation. Pueblo plays host to Colorado Mesa on Saturday. The Colorado School of Mines will be at home in Golden this weekend. The 3-2 Ordiggers are looking to crack the top 25 again and have Western State coming into town. The Mountaineers are in search of their second conference win. Game time is at noon at Campbell Field. Western New Mexico is coming off a shootout loss to Adams State and look to keep pace with Mines as they host Shadron State. RMAC Hall of Fame coach Brad Smith will be on the sidelines for the Eagles for the first time since 2004. Game time at noon in Silver City, New Mexico. The Musket is on the line as Fort Lewis hosts Adams State in their annual rival game. RMAC Offensive Player of the Week QB Tim Jenkins will try to penetrate a stingy Grizzly defense that is just allowing opponents 189 yards per game. Game time is set for 1 p.m. at Ray Dennison Field. New Mexico Highlands looks to end their three-game losing streak as they will host 13th-ranked Kearney. The Lopers need a win if they still want their postseason hopes to stay alive. I'm Chris Poulton, and that has been your RMAC football update.
Thank you, Chris. When we come back, we're going to talk about the RMAC Cross Country Championships on the RMAC Radio Show.